السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back my friends to my YouTube channel Drilling and Workover. This is Abdulaziz Gabr. I am an accredited instructor in IWCF Well Control and IEDC Well Sharp. I am also accredited instructor in IEDC Mud Engineering Basic and Advanced Mud School. Yesterday we have made two videos and they were very, very important videos about the hydraulic control system and about the remote panel to control the POV. Today, inshallah, we will talk about some very important questions that come in the IWCF about the POV control system, hydraulic unit, and the control panel. So pay attention to the questions that we will talk about today. Okay, let's start. The first question, you are drilling ahead and the gauges on your BOB accumulator control system read the following. The BOB has not been operated. Okay, so that has not been operated, this means that everything must be okay. So that the accumulator must be 3000, the manifold must be 1500, the annular must be from 600 to 1500 and it is steady. But here we see the accumulator is 2800 and decreasing means there is leak somewhere. Okay, there is leak somewhere, but if it was this is steady and this is steady and this is steady, this means that the switch, which is automatic hydraulic switch, automatically pressure, automatically hydroelectric pressure switch or automatically hydropneumatic pressure switch are not fixed. So if this is steady, the switch has a problem or the pump has a problem. But if it is decreasing, so there is somewhere a leak. So what is the right answer? The right answer, what is the likely reason of the change? Number B is the right answer. There is a leak in the hydraulic system. But as I told you, if this is steady, so the best answer will be the electric motor stop and start switch is faulty or something like this. Number two question. This is very important, as I told you. Figure below illustrates a hydraulic control schematic for BOB control system. As I told you yesterday, there is here two questions, no more. What is the valves which must be open and what the valves that must be closed. So now the first question, indicate the valves that should be open while drilling. During drilling, as I told you, to be open, you have at least number two and number three must be open and all of them 16, 14, 13, must be open. So check for 2 and 3. Where is here 2 and 3? There is here 2 and 3 and also there is here 2 and 3. Okay, so maybe A, maybe C. Let's check about A. 2, 3, 5, 6, it's okay. 7, it's okay also. 8, 11, 13, as I told you, 13, 14, 16, and blah blah. So the best answers here will be number A, will be number A. Okay. Number B, indicate the valves that should be closed while drilling. So where is the closed valve? First one is 15. Where is 15 here? Can we check about this is 15 and this is 15? So the answer will be A or B. Okay. Number B has valve number two, it's open. As I told you here, number two is open. So the best answer is number A. The valves are 1, 4, 9, 10, 12, 15. So as I told you, 1 and 4 is because they are used only for the skid position or the test position for the pump. So the best answer here for the first one is number A. And for the, closed valves also are number A. Number 3. What is the normal accumulator pressure reading on 3000 PSI hydraulic control unit? The best answer is number C, 3000 PSI. So this is the right answer. Number four, What is the first action should be taken after connecting the open and close hydraulic lines to surface installed BOP? The first one is to make a function test, is to make function test for all the items of the stack. Why? Because they may be plugged or the hydraulic oil may be not in good condition or has some impurities or something like this. So the best answer is number B. So once you make connection, you have to make function test. And also, why you make function test? Because, for example, you may make a difference. You put the open hydraulic line in the closed chamber, for example, and vice versa. So at this time, when you need to close the BOP, it will not make, but it is open. So this is it. So this is very important. In order to, you have to make function test to be to ensure that everything is working okay. Number five, the well has just been shut in using the upper pipe ram. The flow meter reads 2.7.2 gallons. The accumulator pressure has returned to 3000 psi and the manifold pressure has returned to 15 psi. The volume to close here for the gallons, the annular to close is 43 and to open is 35. For the top ram to 12.5 and there is here 12.5 and everything here is the same. So as I told you, in opening the annular, it is less than the volume of the close. This is why, because it takes less volume to close it. So now he told you what the flow meter reads 7.2 gallons for what? For the rams, for the upper ram here. So this is a top ram, it's 12.5. this means that the return is 77.2. this means that the ram may close on the tool joint, or it may not close or make full close around the drill pipe. So that using the data of the table, has the BOP operated successfully? Has the BOP operated successfully, as I told you? No, this is number B. The flow meter value is incorrect. The flow meter value is incorrect. So it may be there is an error in the flow meter, because it has to be 12.5 and the pressures here are here. Let's check about this question. This is very important. As I told you, this is 3000 and this is 15. So both of them are okay. And the volume must be 12.5. Okay, but it is 70.2. So the problem may be in the flow meter. But if the flow meter is correct, okay, but the volume return was not 72, or the pressure here was not 15, for example, 15 psi or 1500. This means that it may close on the tool joint and everything will not be okay. Number six. While drilling, what is the normal hydraulic pressure in the ram opening lines between the BOP hydraulic control unit? As I told you, the normal hydraulic pressure in the ram opening lines, so it will be number B, as I told you, 1500 psi. Why while drilling? Because at while drilling, you are already opening. Okay, so as I told you, once you open the BOP, the open line has 15 psi, but once you close, the closed line has 1500 psi. So the right answer is number B. Number seven, and this is very important question. When operating a stack function from the remote BOP panel, remote control panel means the on the surface BOP installation, the close light, the remote panel here on the driller, for example, or in the tool pusher house, okay, the closed light doesn't illuminate. Okay, doesn't illuminate. This means that, okay, that is a one of two reasons. We have to check also about the pressure. Let's check the pressure. Then the manifold pressure doesn't drop. So it doesn't drop and it doesn't illuminate. This means that the three-way, the four-way, three-position valve has a problem, a stuck or something like this. So which malfunction does this indicate? The three-position four-way valve of the hydraulic BOV control unit failed to shift. So the best answer is number A. After drilling break. After drilling break, as we talk, which means drilling faster. The driller doesn't flow, does a flow check. The well is flowing and the upper pipe ram close function is activated. The driller notes that and reports the following pressure. Accumulator pressure is 3000 psi. That's okay. Annular pressure is 500 psi. It's okay. Also, manifold pressure is 0 psi. So what is the problem here for number 8? Actually, this means that the regulator or the manifold pressure reducing and regulating valve is malfunction. This means that the regulator has a malfunction. Or okay, if this is the right answer here, but if you take with your mind, this means that also some valves may be, for example, the selector valve is stuck on the open position. No, it is not on the open. It may be in the closed, because and not the selector valve. Sorry, the isolation valve. The isolation valve may be in the closed position. So it will be a problem. So the best answer here is that the regulator has a problem number. Annular 13-inch 5K psi 5K annular 13-inch 5000 psi 10K BOV stack. The regulated manifold pressure is 1500 psi. It's okay. And the regulated annular pressure is 1000 psi. So everything is okay until now. What would tell you that the ram has closed correctly? The ram has closed correctly is that there will be a drop in the manifold and in the accumulator. Then it will be re-back again, rebuild up again for it. So the best answer here is the ram light should change from open to closed, and 23 seconds later, the manifold pressure should read 15,000 psi. 15,000 psi. So the right answer here is number D. Number 10. You are supervising the weekly BOB function test on surface 18 3/4 inch on multiply 10K BOB stack. The regulator manifold or the regulated manifold pressure is 15 psi, so everything is okay, and the regulated annular pressure is 1000 psi, so everything now is okay. What would tell you that the annular has closed correctly? As I told you, the annular to be closed, this size needs plus or minus, not plus, no more than 45 seconds to close. So the right answer here would be also number D, which is the annular light should change from open to close, and 43 seconds later, the annular pressure would read or should read 1000 psi. So this is very important note. Number 11. The driller activates a ram close function from the remote BOB panel on a surface BOB installation. The manifold pressure continues to drop and didn't rise back up again. So the manifold pressure continues to drop means there is a leak or something like this. What is the reason for this? Actually, number 11 is number D. There is a leak in hydraulic lines, as I told you. Number 12, this is very important question. You are closing a pipe ram from the remote panel on the surface BOB. The closed light illuminated and the manifold pressure gauge initially drops and then returns to normal. What is the cause of the change in manifold pressure? What is the cause of the change in manifold pressure? So number C is the right answer. The fluid is flowing into the bibrane closing chamber. The fluid is flowing in the bibrane chamber. So this is the best answer, number two. Number 13. In a well control situation with a multi-ram stack annular spool bibrane bibrane, the annular BOB has a severe leak. Okay, in a well control and has a severe leak. The driller activates the upper ram close function and sees that the manifold pressure immediately decreases to zero. The accumulator pressure decreases and the charge pumps activate. So this is normal. Which action is required to shut in the well as quickly as possible? Actually, this is very important question. As I told you, it has number C, the best answer, to place the upper ram in the open position and then close the lower pipe ram. Okay, you will see that you will say that the manifold here has a pressure zero. You can open the bypass at this time. Okay, but place the upper ram in the open position and then close the lower pipe ram. This is the best answer, number 13. Number 14. In a well control situation with a single ram BOB stack, the annular has a severe leak. The driller activates the bibram close function and see that the manifold pressure immediately decreases to zero. The accumulator pressure decreases and the charge pump activates. Which action is required to shut the well as quickly as possible? This is another question. You have to close the ram manually by using the ram lock screw. This is very important, to close the ram by manually ram lock screw. Okay, number 15. Which function on a BOB stack is operated from the annular pressure regulator? The annular pressure regulator, as I told you before, so this is very important, is the annular preventer only. So number B is the right answer. Number 16. What is the function of the master control valve? Master control valve, which gives the air or something like this, on the remote control BOB panel on the rig floor. Number 16. The best answer here is to allow pressuring up the control valves on remote BOB control panel. Okay, it's very important. To allow pressuring up the control valves on the remote BOB control panel. This is very important. Number 17. Given the volumes below, how much hydraulic fluid is required to complete the following operations? This is about the recoverable. This is a question about the recoverable fluid. Operation close then open. So equipment, one annular closed and open, and two bibrams closed and open. And here the annular preventer is 51 for closed and 45 gallons to open. Here also for the bibram, 25 for closed and 22 for open. So to solve this question, this is very important, closed then open. So you make here closed and open for the annular, so you have to add 51 plus 45, then two bibrams close and open, two in 25, which means 50, and two in 22, which means 44. So 50 and 44 plus 51 plus 45, at final it will give you number C, 190 gallons. Number 18. When shutting in the well at BOB panel, a problem may occur that causes doubt about whether the selected function has operated. What has happened if the light illuminates? Light illuminates, but the pressure gauge does not drop. As I told you, it illuminates means that the three-way has been shifted. But pressure don't drop means that there is a problem in the hydraulic lines. So here, number B is the right answer. The hydraulic closing lines of the VOB is plugged. Number 19, on the driller's pneumatically operated panel. Okay, on the driller control panel, remote panel, no problem. For a surface installed VOB, a ram close function was activated and the following observations were made. The light changes from green to red. This is great. Annular pressure didn't change, no problem. Manifold pressure didn't change, no problem. And accumulator pressure didn't change. Okay, so here the problem is the same in the lines, in the control lines. What is the probably the probable cause of this problem? So there is blockage in the hydraulic lines connecting the VOB to the control unit. So number E is the best answer. Number 20, the below shows a set of remote control panel gauge readings. The BOB has not been operated and the BOB accumulator charge pumps, electric and air, are not running. What is the problem with these gauge pressures? Accumulator pressure is 2500 constant. Manifold pressure is 1500 psi. Annular is 700 psi. So here, as I told you, this is constant, this is constant, this is constant. So the problem may be in the pump or maybe in the switch of the pump. So where is here the problem? Number 20 is the accumulator pressure is too low. Or the accumulator pressure here is too low, but there is maybe the problem of the pump. So the best answer here is number 21. The below shows a set of remote control panel gauge readings. The BOB has not been operated and the BOB accumulator charge pumps, air and electric are not running. Okay, what are the possible reasons for the low accumulator pressure readings, and choose two answers. So the best answers here, as I told you, the problem may be due to one of two things. Here, the accumulator charge pump pressure switch has failed. This is number A is the right answer. And also number E is right answer, which there is a leak in the hydraulic accumulator unit. So there is leak in the hydraulic accumulator unit, and also the accumulator charge pump switch have failed. Because this is decreasing, so there is leak. Okay. Number 22. The below shows a set of remote control panel gauge readings. The BOB has not been operated and the BOB accumulator charge pumps, electric and air are not running. What do these gauge reading indicate? Here, 2900 psi slowly decreasing, manifold pressure 1800. So this means that there is leakage from the accumulator to the manifold through the regulator. This is the right answer. So let's check here about the problem number 22. There is a problem with the hydraulic pressure regulating valve. As I told you, there is a problem with the hydraulic pressure regulating valve. Number 23, on a remote BOB control panel on the rig floor, the master control valve allows air pressure to go to each function in preparation for operating the handle and button. Number 23, this is a right answer. This is a right answer, so it's true. Number 24, what is the usable fluid volume of an accumulator bottle according to ABI requirements? As I told you, the usable here must be the volume of the fluid recoverable from an accumulator bottle between the accumulator operating pressure and 200 psi above the bottle pre-charge pressure. So the right answer is number B. Number 25, this is a very important question. What happens when the handle of the BOP remote control panel is activated to close the upper ram preventer? The master valve has been operated also. So the best answer here is number C. The handle operates an air valve in the back of the remote panel. The air activates a piston at the accumulator unit that operates the four-way valve, enabling the flow of the hydraulic flow to the preventer. So this is very important. Number C is the right answer. Number 26. How would you correctly activate a BOP function from the driller remote panel on a surface BOP stack installation? Number 26, the best answer here is number C, push the master button while the BOP function button is pushed. As I told you, it is two-hand operation. Number 27, for which ram operation would the bypass valve on the surface hydraulic BOP control unit be used? The bypass valve, when we use the bypass valve, for the shear and the blind shear ram. So number C here is the right answer. Number 28, which gauges on the remote BOP control panel would show a reduction in hydraulic pressure when the annular preventer is closed? You have to answer. So it will be the accumulator and the annular. So number A is right answer. Number C is also number right answer. So A and C are the right answer. Number 29, which gauges on the remote BOP control panel would show a reduction in hydraulic pressure when the blind shear ram, is closed? You have also two answers. So the accumulator is number one, then the manifold pressure is number two. So the best answers here are number A and number E. The air pressure gauge on the air operated remote BOP control reads zero. Which BOP functions can still be operated? Number 30, very important. So there will be no function can be operated, because when air is zero, this means that the control panel is out of service. So number B is the right answer. No function would be operated. Number 31, if the manifold gauge on the remote BOP control panel reads zero and the other gauges read normal values, so which BOP function can be operated? The manifold reads zero, but the others are okay. So what are the best answer here? Is 31. The best answer here is wait a minute. If the manifold gauge read zero, so okay, the annular preventer will be okay. So number C is the right answer. Number C. Number 32, this is very important question. The driller closes the upper rams from the remote control panel. The green light indicator turns off. Green light turns off and the red light indicator doesn't turn on. The accumulator pressure and the manifold pressure readings decrease then increase again. So what would be the cause of this malfunction? Take care that the close one changes from red, the close one turns from the red turns off for the green. This means that the three-way four position bulb has shifted, but the other one didn't turn on. This means that the bulb has blown or has a problem in the lights. So the best answer for number 32 is number D. There is an electrical fault with the lights. Number 33, on a surface BOP installation, the driller simultaneously pushes the master and choke open buttons. On the remote panel and the lights change color. Lights change color. This confirms that, as I told you, the three way four position valve has shifted. So what do that changing lights confirm? Number 33, as I told you, the number A is the right answer. The panel has correctly functioned and hydraulic opening pressure is applied to the stroke line valve. Number 34, where are the electric pressure activation switches for the remote BOP control panel lights located? The electric pressure or activation switch or micro switch, all this, where is located? Number 34, on the hydraulic BOP control unit, especially inside the three position four way valve. So number B is the right answer. Number 35, what is the normal manifold pressure gauge reading on a 3000 psi hydraulic BOP control unit? Normal manifold is 1500, so number B is the right answer. And the last question, why is the master control valve fitted on the remote BOP control panel on the rig floor? Actually, this is a very important question. Number D, to ensure that all BOP functions are two-hand operation from the driller remote panel. In order, when you need to make the job, you are intended to make the job, but it cannot be done by chance or by fault. This is a very important question. Thank you very much today for this lesson today. If this video appeals to you, share, like, subscribe to your channel, and I hope inshallah we can continue in the other lessons inshallah. And thank you very much for your attention. Goodbye and see you later inshallah. Thank you.